Go ahead, guys.
When I think back over the last couple of years, what has happened and what my memories are, really for your class, it goes back early on. You guys really came together, from my vantage point, you guys came together rather early and helped me out of a real tight bind and helped Central Penn out of a real tight bind. And I'm talking about something that was a negative but really turned into a positive. It was that the arson incidents that happened back when you got started. And there was a guy that needed some help, and your class was smart enough to recognize that, and everyone else that was here then, and we identified the individual and put that behind us. So that's one of the things that stands out over the last couple of years. And on a totally positive note, my coaching experience with the volleyball team, a lot of members of that were in the class of 92, and I've got an autographed ball sitting behind me somewhere, I think, and that's something that I treasure a whole lot. Also, over the last couple of years, some of the changes that took place at Central Penn that your class was the first to experience or really see unfolding is the building of the quad area here, knocking out some of those parking spaces, making the staff walk a little bit further to get to the school, and really sort of a campus beautification type thing, renovating the apartments, or as they've been somewhat affectionately referred to, the projects up here, to make them a little bit more palatable when you stand them next to the townhouses. And then, of course, just recently, the student union gutting the pit and putting in a snack bar up there, the nightclub. So those are some things that stand out over the last couple of years that you all played a big role in. And as far as best wishes and good luck and all that, well, that really goes without saying, I think. But I've heard a lot of great reports, and certainly these are tough times. I would not want to be out in the job market right now, but I've heard a lot of success stories, and I'm really excited to hear where some of the class of 92 is starting out. And I know it's just a start, and everybody's got to start at the bottom, but boy, I'm excited to see where the class is really starting out, and I'm anxious to see where you end up 5, 10, 15 years down the road. And by the way, 5, 10, 15 years down the road, I'll still be here because I'm serving a life sentence at Central Penn. So look me up, keep me informed, read the pendulum, and take care.
persuade young enough not to need a reason. Well, I was for the memories and you were for the fun, and we were both just filling out the season.
I wish that I could stop the hands of time between. sales promotion class is learning how sales promotions are put together, product, service, idea, whatever it happens to be. And one of the objectives of the class is to put together a promotion for a nonprofit organization. In the last 2 years, we've done two really neat promotions. Students are really in charge of who they pick in terms of who they're doing it for and what exactly is done as far as the promotion. Last year, we did a Give Our Troops a Hand, where a local billboard company donated the billboard. We invited the general public to come and make a handprint, and then the billboard itself was posted on Route 83. That was really, really neat, not only to participate in, but to see it actually up, and that the whole area could enjoy seeing it. That was, I thought, very touching. The promotion we did this year was a volleyball tournament for the American Cancer Society. It was one where the students invited groups to get together, some businesses, some just backyard volleyball scrappers, whatever. They had to raise their entry fee, and that money was then donated to the Cancer Society. Well, as a whole, I'd like to wish the entire graduating class of 92 lots of luck. I know the job market is very tough out there this year, in particular to the retail posse. They'll know who I mean. You did a great job while you were here. You went through a lot of headaches. I hope you can see the new background on your video Yearlook when you get it. Don't be afraid to come back and stop in, any one of you, to see what the store looks like and how we're doing.
Champions, we are the champions. taken my bows and my curtain calls. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all, but it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge before the whole human race, and I ain't gonna lose.
It's a
we are the champions, my friends. And we'll keep on fighting till the end.
We are the champions. We are the champions. Who's on the losers? Yes, we are the champions.
Of the world. We are the champions, my friends. And we'll keep on fighting till the end.
Oh, we are the champions. We are the champions. No time for losing, 'cause we are the champions.
In a mock trial competition, it's actually a project that I started my first year here at Central Penn. And we have students, legal assistant students, in the Civil Litigation II class, which they take in their fourth term here, have to put on a mock trial. They play the roles of the attorneys and they play the role of the witnesses. So they have to take the stand, and one of their teammates has to get up and ask them questions. And then they have to be cross-examined by the other team, and they compete against each other, and they get a grade. Lot of work that goes involved. They have to do all of the work as though they were the actual attorney. They do the opening statement, they have to do a closing argument, they have to do a direct examination of a witness and a cross examination of a witness. And we also use court reporting students from here at Central Penn who play the role of the official court reporter, and their role is to transcribe or take down everything that is said here in court. Well, I would like to definitely say good luck. Keep in touch. We like to hear from you and to know what you're doing and know that you've made a success out of your life. We also like to be able to use you as contacts and for you to come back and sit on the jury for the mock trial and to give tips to people who are participating in it. I do have some graduates that come back and form a team, and they actually compete against you're interested, call me.
The fashion show is put on every fall by the senior retailers, and it is part of their fashion analysis course. And they usually pick a charity every year, and we give the proceeds from the fashion show to that particular charity. This year alone, we were able to raise $1,000 for AIDS research, and the name of the organization that we chose was South Central AIDS Assistance Network, SCAN. We try and get as many students involved in the fashion show as we can, not just the senior retailers, but we also have students from the campus come in and be models, and I thought that they did a really good job. I wish the best of luck to the retail posse, way to go, and to the rest of the class 92, congratulations, we're very proud of you, thank you.
I'm too sexy for my love, too sexy for my love, love's going to leave me. It hurts. And I am too sexy for Milan, too sexy for Milan, New York and
shake my little touch on the catwalk.
After spending 2 years with a group of students, I don't think students realize how attached some staff can get to them. Every year I say pretty much the same thing. I look at a freshman class coming in and think, oh Lord, you know, here we go again. And you know, gee, I really miss the seniors. You know, it's that familiarity. And it's like a family in our division. We're very close. And I find myself during the fifth term, right before graduation, believe it or not, dreading the end of that last week of school, because it means for me personally that a lot of these people I won't see again. Some of them, the ones that you get closer to, they'll keep in contact with you, they'll come back, they'll harass you, you know, and all those sorts of things, which I'm always glad for personally. I usually gain a lot of friendships from my senior students, which again I'm very grateful for. I'm very proud of all of them. I'm going to miss all of them. There are a few real crazy ones in this class, of which they know who they are, and I'll probably miss them the most. I would never tell them that to their face though, but I like to wish them all luck, and I hope they keep in contact and they come back and visit us, and so that I can harass them and have them as a guest speaker once in a while, and they can tell all their tales of woe to the freshman class. But I'm going to miss them a great deal, and I wish them much luck in the world and a lot of success. Remember to put me in your will when you're all rich and famous.
Our class, which is actually the management techniques class, sponsors and takes care of all of the planning for breakaway weekend. We try to do an event every summer where we get the whole campus involved. Specifically, I can get my students involved in a planning process. They can carry the planning process out. In breakaway weekend, what we do is we'll set up a picnic for the campus, we'll do a dance for the campus, and our special item is to do a battle of divisions where we can have the divisions compete against each other in a number of events. I think the class of 92 did a great job planning breakaway weekend last summer, and I use them really as a model for this summer's group to work on. I'd like to wish them and everyone in the class of 92 a very good and lucky career.
Thank you. I think with this particular class, I watched a maturational process. It's interesting to see the incoming freshmen in the fall come in, and really we call them greenhorns. They're not accustomed to the dress code, the attendance requirements. In some cases, they're not accustomed to a different level of teaching, which some of the instructors use. And it's easy to pinpoint some students and talk about them and say, well, you know, they're a little wound up. Let's see what's going to happen after the third semester. From my perspective, I see a lot of students in their first and second semester, and I won't see them again until maybe their fourth or fifth semester. And over that time, I see some gradual changes. They become more polished, become more confident. They start to entertain more cultural conversations, and you hear them talking about politics, talking about economics, talking about real life issues which, you know, exist outside of this capsule known as Central Penn. As far as advice I'd give to the class of 92, they've taken a major step, and that's graduating. The next step is lifelong learning. As human beings, we always have the capability of learning at every corner. And if an opportunity opens up to you, that's your opportunity to say, there's something here I can learn. You might learn failure, but in that, it's a learning experience. So my best wishes to the class of 92 is to keep learning. It doesn't have to be book learning. It can always be experience. And that experience can always be brought back to a place like Central Penn.
Midgets of the world, have you ever been in this situation? You go to a health club and all the equipment is too big.
I'll wiggle it just a little bit. I want to see you wiggle it just a little bit. That's true. Wiggle it just a little bit. I want to see you wiggle it just a little bit. That's true. I bet you're moving your body up from side to side. I bet the groove that you're hearing is keeping you satisfied. Dancing by yourself is bad.
We've got a solution. At Small's Gym and Health Club, we offer people 4 feet and under the comfort of a health club with all the right sized equipment.
Wiggle it just a little bit. I want to see you wiggle it just a little bit. That's true. Wiggle it just a little bit. I want to see you wiggle it just a little bit. That's true.
Now you can work out and have a good time doing it. Just give us a call at Small's Health Club and Gym at 1-800-SMALLS-GYM. That's 1-800-SMALS-GYM. You won't regret it.
You have more hair on your back than you have on your head.
Hey, no social commentary from you.
Okay. No, don't. Come on.
All right. That's one for the yearlook.
So with your no knowledge, what do you plan on doing after graduating from Central Penn?
Become a bum. Live at home off my parents. That's what I'm going to do.
That's great, Corey. Tell me, Scott, what have you learned here at Central Penn?
Management skills.
Management skills in doing what?
Managing a business.
Is that everything you learned here at Central Penn?
Yes.
With my education at Central Penn, I plan to further my education as a nurse.
What?
Take two.
With my education that I've acquired at Central Penn, I plan to use it professionally in a doctor's office or a clinic or something like that, and to go on for nursing.
With the education I've acquired from Central Penn, I plan on being a flight attendant or working at an airport in Pittsburgh.
Just look at me, okay? Or look over me. Look over my head. Okay?
I'm sorry. I can't help but laugh because you're so serious.
I am. I know.
Okay, wait a second.
With the education that I'm going to receive here, with the education that I'm going to receive at Central Penn Business School in marketing, I plan on becoming a market researcher in the future.
Look in the camera.
Okay.
With my education here at Central Penn, I plan to join the accounting field in an accounting firm.
With the education I get here at Central Penn, I hope to enter the retail management field and own my own business someday.
The education I got here at Central Penn, I plan on entering the travel field and being a travel agent. Sounds like a great job. I enjoy traveling, and I think it'll be fun.
Good afternoon, Mr. Desai speaking. Oh, thought I was answering my phone there. About my book, How to Succeed the Tony DeStadia Way. I'm a firm believer in that. I think that this book is great. I tell you what, because I like you people, I'll tell you this little secret. I let my old high school coach read my book. And he said to me, you know what he said to me? He says, Tony, it's a great book. And I'm a firm believer in what he has to say. So I'll tell you this. So I think you should read my book. So if you want to be successful like me and be the head coach of the Central Penn Silver Knights, you'll read my book.
my eyes while you're near. Tell me what's happening here. See that I don't want to stay. Goodbye. Our love is frozen in time. I'll be your champion. Champion.